Okay, hello once again students. We have discussed theorem 8.1, 8.2 and 8.3. They have proved as well up to this point. Now we are moving on with theorem 8.4. Okay, so we'll start with the statement of the theorem. Keep in mind, you have to write down the statement of the theorem as well as their proof in your class of copies. Theorem 8.1 is, in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So once again, let me draw the parallelogram for you. This is the parallelogram, and let us name it A, B, C, D. So in this parallelogram, it is given that, actually that is all what is given to us, that A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. What we need to prove is, we need to prove that for this parallelogram A, B, C, D, opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles means A and angle C should be equal, as well as angle B and angle D should also be equal. Okay, so there are two ways in which we can prove that both pair of opposite angles are equal. One way can be that you draw first of all diagonal AD. First of all, you draw diagonal BD and prove that these two triangles are congruent. And by CPCD, you will be able to say that angle A and angle C are equal. Okay. Secondly, what you do is you draw another diagonal and then prove both the triangles congruent. Easily proven. They prove that till now two times. And then you will say that these two angles are equal by corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. This is one way of doing it. Okay. The other way can be like this. See, the other way is by using the properties that we have discussed in chapter lines and angles. Okay. What we discussed in proof. First of all, let me indicate what I am going to do. Then I will write down the proof. First of all, I will say that line AB and DC are parallel. Because line AB and DC are parallel, okay, that means some, and AD I take is as a transversal, that means angle A and angle D will be supplementary. That means angle, value of angle A and angle D will be 180 degrees. Sum of angle A and angle B D will be 180 degrees. That means if angle A is X, angle D will be 180 degree minus X. Okay, get this in your mind. If angle A is X, angle D will be 180 minus X. Now, after that, I will say that AD line and BC line are also parallel. And taking DC as a transversal, we will say that angle D plus angle C should also be equal to 180 degree. Now, value of angle D was 180 degree minus X. Plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. You cancel out 180 degree. X is transported to the right hand side. C become equal to angle X, and angle X was angle A. Okay. This is what we are going to do. And I am going to write down more subjectively. So wait a minute. Let me clear the diagram for you. And then we will start again. First of all, since line AB is parallel to DC, and taking AD as transversal, okay, we will have angle A plus angle D is equals to 180 degree. Why so? Because they are pair of co-interior angles. Okay, or we can say that value of angle D should be equal to 180 degree minus angle A. First equation. Similarly, this time we are taking AD parallel to BC and DC as transversal. Angle D and angle C The sum of angle D and angle C should also be once again equal to 180 degree. Okay, same reason, co-interior angles. Okay, so using the value of angle D from equation A, from equation 1, angle D was equal to 180 degree minus angle A plus angle C as it is equals to 180 degree. That means the value of angle C should be equal to 180 degree minus 180 degree plus angle A, or angle C is equal to angle A. So in this manner, we have proved that one pair of angles are equal. Similarly, you can prove that another pair of angles are equal. You will try all of these steps once again and prove that B and D are equal. Okay, that is the assignment for you to do by yourself. Okay, if you encounter any problem in proving this, kindly watch this part again, and so that you can understand how to prove the next pair of angle as equal as well. Okay, but if this comes in the exam, you have to write down the whole proof. You can also try this by proving that triangles are congruent. Okay, that is a bit shorter, but essentially both methods amount to the same amount of lines. Okay, try this yourself, the second part, and inform me if you encounter any problem. Okay, by using same set of procedures, you can prove that angle D and angle B are also equal. Okay, you can already see, you can already use this part. Angle A and D is 180 degree. You can take this as the first equation, and then taking these two lines as parallel, AD parallel to BC, and this time AB is transverse. Okay, so you have to just do this part once again, and then you will be able to complete the solution. Use your mind, try this a few times, and you will get the answer. Okay, it is good for your practice. All the theorems in this chapter are good for your practice of the previous chapter, congruency. Next is theorem 8.5. Theorem 8.5 is, in a quadrilateral, if each pair of opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. Once again, the same type of thing that happened till now. This time we have pair of opposite angles as equal. A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. So what is given to us is that both pair of opposite angles are equal. In quadrilateral, A, B, C, D, pair of opposite angles, angle A and angle C are equal, as well as angle B and D are equal. Okay, we have to prove that A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Okay, so how do we prove a quadrilateral a parallelogram? We need to prove that both pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. Okay, so how do we prove that both pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other? In this parallelogram, angle A, let that be X, and angle C, let that be X as well, are both equal. And angle B and angle D are also equal. Okay, so I'm going to use the property of sum of all the interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. And secondly, I am going to use the concept of co-interior angles. See, in quadrilateral, ABCD, we are given that angle A is equal to angle C, and let that be equal to X. Similarly, we are given that angle B and angle D are equal, and let those be equal to Y. Okay. Now what we are going to do is we are going to say that in this quadrilateral, since sum of all the interior angle is 360 degree, that means angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D can be said as 360 degree. Now value of angle A was X, angle B was Y, angle C was X, angle D was Y, and that is 360 degree. Okay, X plus X, 2X, Y plus Y, 2Y is equals to 360 degree. Taking 2 as common, X plus Y, 360 degree, X plus Y should be equal to 180 degree. Okay, in place of x, first of all, I will write down x as angle A and y as angle B. So by doing that, what is the result? Hence, angle A plus angle B is 180 degree. That means this angle and this angle are supplementary. Hence, since co-interior angles are equal, therefore AD line is parallel to BC. We have proved one pair of line is parallel. Also, instead of angle A, I will write down angle C and keep angle B as it is. Once again, co-interior angles are equal. So in that manner, line AB is parallel to line DC. Okay. Finally, you will write down the statement, since both pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral are equal, then it is a parallelogram. I don't have much place to write it down. Okay. It is very clustered as it is. Okay. I hope you don't mind. So finally, I will write down the line, since both pair of opposite sides of quadrilateral are parallel, so ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, in this manner we have proved that if a pair of opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. Again, we have also proved that if it is a parallelogram, both pair of opposite angles are essentially equal. Okay, next we come to theorem 8.6. Theorem 8.6 states that diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, so this time it is quite different. From sides and angles of a parallelogram, we have graduated to come to diagonals of a parallelogram. We have completed the theorems about sides as well as angles of the parallelogram, and now we have come to diagonals of a parallelogram. Now, first of all, let me name it A, B, C, and D. A, B, C, D is your parallelogram. One of the diagonals is BD and another diagonal is AC. Okay, and let's say that their point of intersection is O. So what is given to us? Given to us is that ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, ABCD is a parallelogram. That is what given to us. So now what we need to do is we need to prove that it's diagonal bisect each other, that diagonals bisect each other. Okay, what we essentially need to prove that this length DO, this length OB are equal, as well as this length AO and this length OC are equal. Okay, so students, let me give you a clear picture. If for a parallelogram, you need to prove something related to its sides as well as its angles. Okay, if in a parallelogram, you need something to prove relating to its sides or its angles, then in that case, you only need one diagonal of the parallelogram. Okay, but in case you need something related to its diagonal, you need to prove something related to its diagonals, then you need both of its diagonals. If they are given to you, then you draw them as they are given. If they are not given to you, then you use that as a construction. Keep that in mind as we move on to the exercise. Okay, so this time the triangles that I am going to take is change. I'm going to focus in triangle AOB and triangle DOC. I'm going to focus in triangle AOB and triangle DOC. These two smaller triangles. Okay, both the triangles together divided this parallelogram into four triangles. I'm taking just one pair. Okay, and I'm taking vertically opposite pair. I'm taking these triangles. Okay, or I could have taken this triangle. Okay, in this both pair of triangles, you can use any of the pair of the triangles. I usually use these two triangles. Okay, in these two triangles, first of all, you have, since AB is parallel to DC, okay, so alternate and interior angles are equal. What are the alternate interior angles? Angle ODC, first of all, angle OBA will be equal to angle ODC. How so? When we take BD as transversal. Okay. And secondly, we will have angle OAB equal to angle OCD. This time we have taken AC as transversal. Okay, we have taken two angles and one side between them will be AB length and DC length are equal, because in one of the previous theorems we have proved that opposite sides of a parallelogram, this is short form for parallelogram, are equal. We have proved that in one of the theorems previously. Okay, so in this manner, by ASA congruency, both of these triangles will be congruent. Triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. Okay, once you have both of these triangles as congruent, you can say by CPCT, first of all, AO length and OC length are equal, hence O is midpoint of AC, and secondly, OB length and OD length are equal. OB length and OD length are equal. As I'm saying things, okay, try to identify what I am stating in the diagram. Okay, by doing that only you will be able to understand the theorem well. Otherwise, you will be just mugging the theorem. Hence you have O as midpoint of DC as well. DB. Okay. So, in parallelogram, AB, CD, diagonals bisect each other. Diagonal bisect each other means both the diagonals are passing through the midpoint of each other. Okay.